I want to ask a little bit about the atmosphere as it relates to Canelo. He's going to fight here in the stadium. You know, by Jerry's estimates and what you and Oscar have said, there may be as many as 50 or more thousand people here. It's going to be mostly a Canelo Alvarez crowd. There'll be maybe a smattering of Brits, but this is a Canelo Alvarez house. You guys have been in your fights, Vinny, Oscar, and Bernard, in fights where you were largely, well, not so much Bernard, but Oscar and Vinny, the hometown guy, the favorite, you know, the popular fan favorite. Can you talk about what it's like, Vinny, I'll start with you, what it's like to walk into an arena where every single person is rooting for you, and some people will say that's a great thing, others would view it as a lot of pressure. How did you feel going into your arenas in Rhode Island with the whole fans behind you?
First, let me say Bernard is a badass. and the main thing about that guy, it's called discipline. This dude had more discipline than anybody. Oscar, you know what I mean.
Still does?
Still does, I know. And I'm amazed.
How many miles did you run this morning?
Four.
See, I'm amazed at that. I want to go out and drink. I don't drink till 10 o'clock at night, but after that, I'm
I haven't had one of those in 30 years.
Hey, I'll
be 52 in January.
I know. I got you. But,
we're talking about what it's like to go into the packed house and everyone's for you.
I'm going to tell you a hysterical story. I'm fighting Roberto Duran. And now I'm kind of like the young cocky kid, and he's like.
I mean, you hear that? I'm fighting Roberto Duran, right? Right. Like nothing, right? Like nothing.
Yeah, no,
man.
No,
right.
One of the guys. I started.
This is a bad man right here.
I love that guy. I started boxing because I loved Ali and Duran. I couldn't believe I was fighting him. You know, I'm like, oh my God, I'm fighting my hero. So, anyways, he gets up at the first press conference and he starts talking like. Dogging the shit out of me, and I went, oh my God, it like went through my heart. He's like, yeah, your playboy girlfriend's gonna have to put your ass, take care of you when I put you in the hospital. I'm like, what the fuck is this guy saying to me? Oh my God, I can't believe that, I love this guy. So anyway, so I got ready.
It's a family show.
I know, and families swear too. But, so I get ready for the fight, and now I think, all right, the crowd's gonna be with him. Right, this cool, you know. Don't worry about the crowd; they ain't fighting him. Walk in the ring. They introduce me. So now they introduce me in Atlantic City, sold-out place, Donald Trump's place. They introduce me, and I was just, wow! I'm like, oh my God, the fans are with me. Wow, this is really cool. I'm gonna really kill this guy. And then they introduce. And in this corner, Manos de Pedros from Panama, Roberto Duran. The roof almost fell off. The house almost came down. I said, okay, Baz, man. They're not in the ring. Don't worry about it. So it's a big thing when the crowd's on your side. It's a good feeling for people. But when the fight gets down and it gets going, the crowd don't matter.